Hi, welcome to the Chris Waller Racing Review Show. We had a good week's racing last week, Charlie, with the treble at Canterbury.
Yeah, fantastic week. We had Salomon, who's obviously redeemed his luckless run the start before, into the winner's circle again, and it was good to see the group of owners very excited by his win. We also had Cosmic Engine, who was coming off the back of just one trial, so it was pleasing to see that he was fit and ready to produce a winning first up run. And
Shield Wall
up in distance, first attempt at the 1900, but saw it out well and was steered well by Glyn.
We had an awesome day at Rosehill as well with five winners. First one was Unforgotten.
Hold still there, Kerrie. No, Unforgotten, very classy filly. She's obviously in her three-year-old year, so in her classic year, and hopefully we can get her through to those types of races. Obviously we're taking it one step at a time, and she's on the quick backup, which we'll touch on a bit later on.
We then had Black on Gold, which was first of the double for us for Cathy.
Yeah, absolutely. Black on Gold, back on a slightly drier track, and got the job done well. So he's coming along nicely and in for another good preparation.
And Cars Off, yeah. Nice win.
Good win. Second up to 1800 was a bit of a concern. He had to switch off to ensure that he could win, and he did that nicely. So he's another exciting Saturday class horse who's come back down from having his first half of his, well, the beginning of his preparation in Brisbane. So it's really a winning formula for us, and something that we'll continue to do.
And Zambolina.
Zambolina, yeah. Like Black on Gold and in fact Wayanka, they were both just luckless the week prior on softer tracks. They were racing on a good four on Saturday at Rosehill, and they all returned into the winner's circle. So it was the end of a very good day.
Hey, the day was capped off by Wayanka.
You've already said Wayanka.
You didn't let me say it.
No, the day was capped off by a Group 1 Quinella though in Melbourne, which was awesome to see Shillelagh fly home under a light weight of 52 kilos. Excellent win, obviously, for in terms of her pedigree page, it's far more important that she wins a Group 1 than the unlucky Tom Melbourne, who seems to bump into one too good each time. But we'll touch on his race this weekend, where he could have potentially step up to 2,000 metres and try and get his Group 1.
And Durbin, My Giuliano, got the money there.
Yeah, very good win for My Giuliano. So winners in all three states, suggesting the stable's in great form heading into Cup Week.
So Melbourne Cup Day, our winner came in the way of So You Win.
Yeah, very good win from him. He was sort of held up in the straight, and when the gap finally came for him, he burst through for a comprehensive victory. So certainly looks like he's in for a very good preparation. And we don't usually mention our provincial winners due to us just having too many winners. but we will mention Bazina, who won well on Melbourne Cup Day at Kembla, which was nice to see. Patrick O'Donnell, who rode for the stable two Christmases ago, he's just arrived back in Oz and he's here to stay, and he rode the horse nicely for a comprehensive win, so hopefully that can be the start of a good season for Patrick.
Right, so let's get into our runners for Saturday. We've got Tom Melbourne at Flemington on Saturday.
Yeah, he steps up to the 2,000 metres. Michael Walker's aboard. The barrier in barrier 14 in a field of 15 is obviously less than ideal. He's a horse who does need to have cover and does need to switch off and relax, as we saw in the Toorak. It's an absolute necessity for him. So Chris has yet to make a final call as to whether he'll take part in Group 1 on Saturday or whether we can wait and send him to Perth. Obviously the barrier does just mean that we'll have to ride him in there's the last sort of three or four runners in the field, or you'd be likely to be posted wide without cover. So we'll have a final call will obviously be made by Saturday morning. But he's pulled up well at this stage, and Michael Walker's got a good set of hands on him, so he should be able to switch off, and obviously the 2,000 metre distance is no problem to him at all.
We then have Andaz in the Emirates.
Yeah, stepping up to 1,400. He gets in with a nice light weight of 54 kilos. He's got a good barrier. Ben Mellum knows the horse well. it's just sort of one last run for the preparation, see what distance he can get up over to, for his next preparation. The backup isn't something that we usually do that much of, but he's pulled up well and the race looks right for him.
And then to Rose Hill, the day kicks off with Madame Rouge.
Yeah, she's really nice filly. She trialled extremely well. Obviously, there's only one horse in the race who's had a career start, so a lot of fresh faces at the races. And look, going off her trial form and her work at home, then she's certainly a live chance.
We've then got Unforgotten.
Yeah, she's on the quick backup. Extra 200 metres will certainly suit her. Jay Ford retains the ride. Look, she's going as well as ever, and if this will be more than likely her last run prior to heading to the paddock and coming back for what we hope to be a massive autumn.
Vassal and Great Glen in the next.
Yeah, Vassal's coming down from Queensland where he's been racing very well. The 2400 metres in what looks to be a relatively weak race, with obviously the excellent prize money Sydney has to offer. So it's got a big weight, but Ty Anglin will no doubt be able to get the best out of him. And Great Glen stepping up to the 2400 metres is a slight concern. He does need to do everything right. He needs to switch off and relax to ensure that he sees out the distance well. But we do need to see a bit of improvement come from him. And I'm hoping that the distance will do that.
We then got Morta Platoon and I Am Serious.
Yeah, Morta Platoon was disappointing last weekend. Maybe it was the due to the drier track this weekend. Hopefully we will still be racing on that softer track, which he won on the start prior to last weekend's run. If it did dry out and on the quick back up, we might look at taking him elsewhere, but at this stage on a soft track, we're hoping for a turnaround in his form from his previous start. And of course, I'm Serious, who was dual accepted. We've decided to run her in the 1800 metre race, getting her out in the distance, which the owners and Chris were both keen to do. The barrier is slightly awkward, but she's looking for three in a row, and we can't fault her form on her track work. So if she sees out the distance, then she's of course a live winning chance.
Dagny, what are your thoughts there?
Yeah, distance is right. She doesn't mind if it is soft or good. She's got form on all surfaces. Her work in the last 7 days has been of a high standard, and she's a city horse all day long. And hopefully she can bring home the cookies on Saturday.
We've got In Times of War and Overstep.
Yeah, In Times of War blew the whole race at the start last weekend, and hopefully that won't happen again. The extra 100 metres certainly isn't a concern. She should switch off well, and she's an ultra consistent filly, so hopefully we can bounce her back into her usual form. And Overstep, she comes up from Melbourne. Her first up run was a little bit disappointing, but we've had a little bit of a gap between runs, which has allowed her to freshen up, and I'm happy with the way she's working here at Rose Hill. And providing she can get cover and switch off and do things right in the early stages, there's no reason why she won't finish off strongly.
And we have just the one runner at Doomben in Monasterio.
Yeah, Monasterio, he's second up, stepping up to the mile distance. The awkward barrier does make things slightly tricky, but we'll just try and ride him conservatively to ensure he switches off and relaxes. Due to the quick tempo that they usually run along at in Doomben, it should ensure that he can get on home strongly in the concluding stages, and hopefully he can run them all down.
All right, well, thanks, Charlie. Happy punting.
No, thank you, Kerrie.